वंदेहं श्री गुरु।
The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 6th canto, 1st chapter, text number 7, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 15th of June, 1975, in Honolulu, Hawaii.
Sri Rupam Chakrajatam
नचीद हैवापतितं यथाघसः कृतस्यको ज्ञान मनयुक्त पाणिभि ध्रुवं सवै प्रत्त नरकानुपैति जे कीर्तिता मे भवत स्थिगम जातन। लास्ट वीक वी डिस्कस परीक्षित महाराज सिंपैथी विद द सफरिंग ह्यूमैनिटी। दिस इज वैष्णव। The Vaishnava, our devotee, he is a perfect sympathizer for all suffering human. Others, sympathy is not perfect. They are planning so many things, opening hospitals or charitable dispensaries, schools, lunatic asylum. These are all public sympathetic activities, but they are not. They are of course good to some extent. If a man is suffering from the bodily ailments, if he is given some relief in the hospital, or if the society is not educated, give him education, this is all good work, undoubtedly. But the ultimate good work is not known to them. They are taking care of the external symptoms. Why a person, a living entity, is put into that condition? And if that condition is ended, that is real sympathy. A person is suffering from some disease, he goes to the doctor, physician, he gives some medicine, immediate some relief from the pain, this is one sympathy. And there is another sympathy, that why the man is getting such disease and suffering, why not stop the cause of the disease? That is real sympathy. Now we can see in our front there is a tree standing for many years, and he has to stand in scorching heat, torrents of rain, pinching cold. He cannot move an inch. And if we think seriously, suppose if I would have been put into that condition, to stand up here for 500 or 5,000 years, you cannot move an inch, and you bear all the suffering, scorching heat, storm, would I agree to do that? No, I'll not agree. But the tree is also a living entity. He's a living being. I am also a living being. So I am put in a different condition of life, and the tree is put in a different condition of life. Why? Why this distinction? Is there any upper hand, superior judgment that one is put in the condition of standing tree and one is put in the beautiful human body freely moving, there must be, because we are all living entities. We are all soul, spirit soul. We are simply put in different dresses. That from the beginning of the instruction of Bhagavad Gita, this lesson is the first lesson. We have to understand. Dehi nasmi yatha dehi, kaumar yauvanam jara, tatha dehantara prapti dhira sattva namiyati. 99.9% they do not understand this philosophy, especially in the modern age. Manda samanda matayo, they are very, very dull rascals. This is the challenge. Manda, manda means dull, no intelligence. A very simple truth Krishna is explaining to Arjuna. It is authoritative statement, because Krishna says, and Krishna says not unreasonably, very reasonably, and giving very common example, that asmin dehe, within this body, the proprietor of the body as the spirit soul is there. And on account of this, dehinasmin jatha dehe, because the living entity is within this body, therefore the bodily changes are taking place. What is that change? Dehinasmin jatha dehe, kumara yauvanam jara. The body is sometimes child, sometimes boy, sometimes young man, sometimes old man. His body is changing. Who cannot understand this? The child, the small child, is dancing. Now that child will get the body of a young man like it. Everyone knows it. This body will change. Where is the difficulty? And Krishna is giving this common example. Tatha dehantara prapti, as we are experiencing this change of body, similarly you take it that this body also will change. An old man like me, the next body is there. Either further old man or after death another body. This is tremendous truth. Tatha dehantara prapti. Dehantara prapti means to get another body. So we are experiencing in our this life, it is taking change so swiftly that we cannot understand how the body is changing, but it is changing. So similarly this body will change. Tatha dehantara prapti, and we have to change the body after death according to my mental condition. Because we have got two bodies, the subtle body and the gross body. This gross body is finished, it is no more working. Just like at night, the gross body does not work. You are thinking, I am sleeping. Sleeping means the body is so much tired, it is no more working. But your another body, which is made of mind, intelligence and ego, subtle body, that is working. Everyone has got this experience. The subtle body takes you to another place or another condition. You are dreaming that you have gone to the jungle. You are meeting some animals. The tiger is there coming to attack you, and you are crying, here is tiger, tiger, tiger. And the man who is not dreaming, he says, where is tiger? Why you are crying? But he is actually, the result is there. Don't think the result is not there. In dream, you are thinking your lover is there, you are embracing, and you get discharged. Not that, that you are not working, and it is not, there is no result. There is result. I cannot see what is the result, what you are dreaming. I am fool, I do not know. But the man who is living, he is experiencing. Similarly, change of body means we are carried by the subtle body to another gross body. This is the process, nature's way. You cannot say that I will not change body. No, you will be forced. Just like a young man can say, I will not become old man. No, nature will force you to become an old man or change your body. This is the law of nature. You cannot surpass the laws of nature. Similarly, change of body, that is forced by the nature. Prakriti, kiramanani, dharani, sarvani, sarva. Prakriti, by the nature's law, we have to do. We are completely under nature's law. And we are declaring independence. This is our foolishness. This is our foolishness. So, in the fifth chapter, at the end of the fifth chapter, Sukadeva Goswami has described the different sufferings body in the hellish condition. Then we are, according to change of body, we are not only going through the evolutionary process of different types of body, as we have got experience here, the aquatics, the trees, the plants, the insects, the birds, the beasts, and then human beings. Similarly, after human being, if we do not work properly with our advanced consciousness, then we go down again in the hellish planet that are down this universe. And if we act piously, then you go to the upper planetary system. This moon planet is also one of the upper planetary system. But you cannot go by Sputnik. That is not possible. It is all foolishness. The moon planet is situated above the sun planet. They are not going to the moon planet. Therefore, they have stopped their propaganda. So, above that moon planet, there is Venus, there is Jupiter, there is Mars, and so many others. So, in the Shastra it is said, urdhaṁ gacchanti sattva-svā. If you act very piously, in the mode of goodness, then you are promoted to the higher planetary system. And if you do not work in the modes of goodness, in the modes of passion, then you remain in this planet and become changed into so many bodies. And if you still work jaghanna guna vittistha adho gacchanti tam, if you are so abominable that you do not work as a human being and just like animal, then you go to the hellish condition. This is nature's law. So, Sukadeva Goswami has described all the planetary systems, where and how they are situated, how many minds they are different from one another. The calculation of the whole universe is made there. The diameter is described, 4 billion miles up and down, this way and that. And where the sun is situated, and how far above the sun the moon is situated, how far above the moon, the Mars, Jupiter, everything is clearly described. And where the hellish planets are situated, and how in the hellish planets different sinful men are suffering. So, Parikshit Maharaj, after hearing that is Vaishnava, he did not take care of the other things. He immediately took care of the suffering planet, because that is the Vaishnava nature. Vaishnava has no problem. He is servant of God, representative of God. But he is feeling the sufferings of the humanity. That is Vaishnava. He feels, these people are suffering. let us give some information from the Shastra so that they can be relieved from the suffering condition. So in this Kali Yuga, especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, that you are chanting and dancing before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so he is so merciful that if you continue this process, you are guaranteed that you will never go to the hellish planet. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Very simple thing. If you simply chant and dance before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Kalo Shanti Tanai Jagai Jajanti Hi Sumedasa. This is the description of the Shastra. Krishna Vannang Tisha Krishna Shangapangasaparsadam Jagai Sankirtanai Prai Jajanti Hi Sumedasa. This is the method of worship in this Kali Yuga, in this age. What is that? That Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishna. The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, descends as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, whose complexion is very beautiful. Tisha, Tisha means by the complexion of Krishna, not blackish. As Krishna is blackish, this incarnation is not blackish. It is just like golden, molten gold. So Tisha Krishna and Krishna Varnam, he is Krishna, or always chanting Hare Krishna. Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishna Sangapangasta Parsadam. And his associates, just like Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Prabhu and Gadadhar and Sivas and many others. So he is always in association of his assistants, who are assisting him in propagating the Sankirtan movement. Gaurangera Sangi Gane Nitya Siddha Boli Mane. Anyone who is preaching the Sankirtan movement, he is associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sangha Pangasta Bhajani Advaita Prabhu Nityananda Prabhu help. Similarly, anyone, even after that, who is trying to help the propagation of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission, praise this Sankirtan movement all over the world, he is also associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Gaurangara Sangi Gane Nitya Siddha Bolimane. They are not ordinary humans. Nitya Siddha, ever liberated. So, if we follow this leadership and if we act very nice, very easily, Sukham, there is one verse in Bhagavad Gita, Raja Gujjam, Pavitram Idamuttamam, Kottamabha. To perform this activity, it doesn't require much energy, much austerity. Simply, you join the Sankirtan movement and ecstasy, you dance, take prasadam. By this process, you are guaranteed will never go to the hellish planet. So this Sankirtan movement is so nice. Anyway, don't disbelieve. It is in the Shastra. So there are hellish planet, hellish birth, 8,400,000 species of birth. So we have to take information from the Shastra. Don't be foolish. You create your mental concoction. No, that will not help you, because you are not free. Nobody is free. Everyone is under the grip of material laws. Even if I think I'm free, that is my foolishness. I'll be forced to act. Even if I do not want to become old man, I'll be forced to become old man. If I, after this giving up this body, if I, suppose nature is offering me a dog's body, if I say, no, I will not accept this. No, you will be forced to accept it. That is nature, sir. But you can save yourself if you follow conscientiously. That is Krishna consciousness. If you keep yourself in Krishna consciousness and act accordingly, then you will be saved. Otherwise, there is no saving. Tathādehāntara prāpti. You will have to accept another body. And what is that body? that is not stated. That will be decided at the end of your life, at the time of your death, at the condition of your mind and intelligence at that time. If at that time you are thinking of your pet dog, what will happen to my pet dog? I will leave. Let me leave some of my property in his name. Then you can leave the dog with some property, but you are going to be dog. This is law of nature. You may love your dog very nicely and leave some property, but where you are going, sir, that is under the nature's law. You cannot say that you've given so much property to the dog, why shall I accept it? No, because your mind is absorbed in the thought of dog, therefore you must take the dog. This is nature. Therefore we have to train up our mind. Instead of dog, you must train up your mind to think of God. Then you'll be there. Tattādi yaṁ punarjanma naitimā. Anyway, so Parikshit Maharaj asked, now how these people can be delivered from this hellish condition of life? That was his question to Sukadeva Goswami. He asked this question, adunāyo mahābhāgo jathaiva narakānnaraha nāna ugrajātunā nneyāt tanme bhakkhātum marhasi. I have heard you, my dear sir. Sukadeva Goswami is the guru of Parikshit Maharaj. So he became very much anxious. Oh, so many people are suffering in the hellish condition. So he immediately asked his spiritual master, kindly let me know how these living entities who are suffering in this way can be saved, can be delivered from the severe pain of hellish condition of life. This was his question. So the answer is given, that nacet ihaiva apachitin jatang hasa kritasya kujyan mana uktapani bhi durvang sabai preta narakanu paiti jeki titame bhavata stigumaja. My dear Parikshit, if before the end of the life we are committing so many sinful activities, just like in the Western countries, they are killing so many birds and bees, especially cows, thousands and thousands. They are all becoming implicated. You have no right. Even Christ says, thou shalt not kill. So, we are responsible. Even if we kill one mosquito, we are responsible. It is not man-made law that if you kill a human being, then you are punished, and if you kill another animal, you are not punished. This is man-made law, according to our convenience. We have to eat the animal, therefore there is no punishment for animal killing. But God is, for everyone, the same, every living entity is part and parcel of God. So they have been given an opportunity to undergo the punishment or enjoyment. You cannot disturb him. You cannot disturb him. Just like you are living in an apartment according to your position. But if I forcibly ask you, go out of this apartment, then I will be punishable by the law. I have no right to get you out from that apartment. Similarly, every living entity, by the laws of nature, all laws of nature, is imprisoned or allowed under certain apartment, either in the body of a tree or a human being or demigod or cat or dog. These are all ordered. So you cannot get out the living entity soul by force from that body, then you will be punished. The living entity is never killed, but you have no right to get him out from that body. That is sin. If you cargo, that what is the harm if I kill one animal? Because it is said, na hannate hannamane sarire, the living entity soul is never killed, even after the annihilation of this body. That is all right. But you cannot force, just like if you get one person by force, get out from his apartment. He is not dying, of course, but still it is criminal, because you are forcing him to go out of the apartment. So, that is the law of nature. You cannot force anyone to get out of the body, then you are punishable. So the punishments are different. So therefore, Sukadeva Goswami is informing, na ced ihaiva apachitin jathaham. You have done something sinful activity, and if you do not atone for it before your next death, kritasya kujyana manoktopanevi, the sinful activities which you have done with your body, with your mind, with your senses, that you have to atone for it. Otherwise, dhruvam savai preta narakanupaiti. Dhruvam, surely, he will get the different types of various condition of life. Je kitita me, as I have already described, bhavata stigma jatana before you, how they are suffering. This is karmakandya, which means for one sinful activity, another pious activity, counteraction. But this will be discussed in the next verse, that prayaschitta. Prayaschitta means atonement. That is the next verse here. Tasmat puraiva siya papa niskito jateta mitta rabipaddata atmana. Dosasya drishtya gurulaghavaga jatha viṣak cikat seta rujanga nidānavit. So according to a degree of sinful activities, so a degree, the most sinful activity according to Vedic information, to kill a child, to kill a woman, to kill a brahmana, and to kill a cow. This is very abominable punishment. Child, brahmana, cow, and woman. There are to be given protection by the laws of Vedic instruction. They are to be protected. So, this will be very carefully done. Sri Shuddha, Dijabandhuna, Sri, they are considered either as innocent as the child, or as innocent as the animal. So they should be given always protection. So here it is said that tasmat purbaiva asu iha papa niskito. Very, we do not know when we shall die. But we must know he has committed so many sinful activities that for before the next death. Jateta mrittu ravipaddo atmana. Mrittu, we have to die. Before death, we have to make the atonement. Otherwise, Parikritma Sukadeva Goswami said, as I have already described, the different position of hellish condition of life, one has to suffer. And how it will be done? Dosasya drishtya labhu guru lagabhojat. There are degrees. The first degree is sinful activity, I have already said. There are different degrees. So, as the physician, the example is given that viṣak cikitsata rujāna nidānavit. Viṣak means physician. He have got some pain, disease, ailments. He gives you, suppose you are suffering, that he sees that this suffering is not very serious. All right, you take this tablet, what is called anacin. And he will be relieved. So, if he commits some sinful activity, he goes to a very expert brahmana. They are called Bhattacharya. They are special, just like there are physicians for treatment of the disease, there are highly learned brahmanas who are called Bhattacharyas. People go there, say, I have committed this sin, what I have to do. So they prescribe that you do like this. So similarly, as you go to the physician, you have to go to consult an expert learned brahmana that I have committed. But people used to understand that what is sinful and what is pious. Now people are so downtrodden, so dull, manda, that they do not understand what is sinful, what is pious. They are going on doing all nonsense without any care. And there is no question of consulting physician or learned man. So these things are all gone. And in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time, there was misuse also of this. It's like sometimes the physician does not give him the proper medicine just to keep him under treatment and take money from him. He continues. Similarly, in these days, things are being deteriorated. So even you go to a learned Brahmin, he does not give you the proper instruction, he wants to exact some money from you. Therefore, things have gone, everything, very bad. Even in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's time, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was there, one gentleman, he was made into a Mahavira. It's a long story. The shortcut is, he was a very rich man, and the Nawab of Bengal, Hussain Shah, when he was a boy, he was his servant. Later on, he became the Nawab, the king. So one day, the Nawab was being massaged, and his wife saw that there is a stripe on the back. So he asked the Nawab, "What is this?" So he stated that when I was a poor boy, I was servant of Buddhimanta Khan, and I committed some wrong, so he whipped me with a cane. "Oh, then it is a sign that you are a servant of Buddhimanta Khan sometimes before. If people will say and he will explain that it is an insult for you, you know, what is that? He was just like my father. He chastised me. I don't mind." "No, no, no, no. You should kill him so that he may not say to anyone that you are sometimes his servant." So Nawab disagreed. Nawab said, "No, no. He treated me just like my son, and I accepted him as my father. It is not possible to kill him." Then the queen suggested that at least you make him a Mahavira, then that he will be punished. So the king or the Nawab said, "All right, I said, because in those days to make a Hindu a Mahavira, it was very easy. The Mahavirans, they have got a pot, it is called Badna. So if the Mahavira takes little water from the Badna and sprinkles upon a Hindu, then Hindu community will immediately reject him. Oh, he has become Mahavira." This was the Hindu community. Therefore, so many Mohammedans were there in India. And ultimately, by the British policy, they divided. They are not actually Mohammedans coming from Turkey or from West. They were lower class Hindus. But the Hindus were so foolish that even Mohammedan sprinkles some water in this way. Then he becomes Mohammedan and he is rejected. In this way, the Mohammedan population was there. Anyway, that was done in the case of Buddhimanta Khan. The Nawab called him one day and took little water from his pot and sprinkled, and it was, "Now he has become Mohammedan, he has become Mohammedan." So he went to a Bhattacharya. "So what is the atonement? Now I have become Mohammedan. Let's see the concept." And the Bhattacharya said that you drink 1 pound of molten lead. How it is possible? That is the atonement. So in this way he was baffled. He went to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He was very respectable man. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu laughed that this is the condition of the Hindu society. So he said that I tell you that you give up your family life, you go to Vrindavan and chant there Hare Krishna. That's all. That will be. So at the present moment, that is the only atonement. Whatever we have done and whatever we are doing, the atonement is chant Hare Krishna mantra. So we haven't got to go to Vrindavan. We have brought Vrindavan Navadvip here in Hawaii, in this temple. So you take this process of atonement, but don't commit sinful life anymore. Don't think that now I am chanting and I can go on committing all sinful activities. That is apara, that is offense. Namnat bala jasahi papa buddhi. If we think like that we have got an instrument chanting of Hare Krishna mantra, which nullifies or neutralizes all kinds of sinful activities, it is very good instrument. Then I go on committing all kinds of sinful activity, and sometimes I go in the temple and chant Hare Krishna and dance. No, don't take this. You must stop your sinful activities. Hare Krishna mantra has got the power to neutralize the resultant action of your all sinful activities, that's a fact. But don't accumulate again sinful activity. Then you are safe. If you take it as an instrument, now let me commit sinful activities and chant Hare Krishna, then that is very dangerous. You'll never be excused. Just like sometimes the Christians do, they go to the church, make some atonement, and again does the same thing next week, and again goes to the church, again atonement. This is not good. If you make atonement for your sinful activities by some process, just like we are prescribing this process, chant Hare Krishna, surely your sinful action is nullified. But don't commit it. That is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He delivered Jagai Madhai. They are very sinful. Sinful means they are born in a respectable Brahmin family, but by bad association they become drunkard, woman hunter, cheater, and plunderer like. They are very sinful. The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivered. How delivered? The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made them promise that you will not do any more all these things. They said, yes, he promised, he shall not. Then you are delivered. Similarly, by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, all these sinful activities are excused. But you don't commit it again. Therefore, we are prescribing, along with chanting of Hare Krishna mantra, we are asking our disciples, no illicit sex, no meat eating, no intoxication, no gambling. If you save yourself from these four pillars of sinful activities and chant Hare Krishna mantra, not very much, only 16 now, minimum, then you are saved from the hellish condition of life for which Parikshit Maharaj was so disturbed, and he was asking how to save these people from this hellish condition of life. This will be described more and more, and the book is there, Bhagavat, you can read. We have published so many Srimad Bhagavatam editions, nicely explained in English, so they are being accepted, even educated circle, school, college, and big professors. But you also try to read this Bhagavatam, and don't commit sinful activities.